Hello, Serge here from the back porch. I recently had a golf school and ran into an unusual situation, unusual in the sense that the student's answer to me and comments he was making during the swing was something I hadn't seen before from other students who had the same issue. And the issue was basically, when I do a golf lesson and I do my diagnosis and prescription, I have two things that I fill in terms of the swing, and one of them is power level. I write in there good, pretty good, whatever, or too slow, too loose, or whatever like that. And muscle tone, I would have loose, lazy, lethargic looking, or too tight and tense, or whatever. And this student got he was I graded him as the swing was a little too loose, a lazy type looking, lethargic looking, and his muscle tone, I had him down as a little too soft, and not athletically ready. And so he was hit. He had the surge swing down pretty good. He'd been practicing it for a long time. He had basically a pretty solid setup. He had the club up about three quarters nicely. Got to a pretty good tee finish, but it was just instead of seeing that good athletic ready, nice swing through the ball, he was kind of, you know, to begin with, just kind of very, very loose. It was like, and lazy. It was like he had no energy. He was just basically swinging the club. But the irony was that he was hitting halfway decent shots, but the ball just wasn't going anywhere near as far as it should, because it wasn't being swung as fast. And so, or fast enough. But the irony was when he hit a bad shot, and I mean, he had somewhere where he was coming through and he could hit it with the face wide open and just hit one 40 yards to the right, and then the next one could flip it over a little bit too much in to the left. And every time he hit one of those really bad shots, or even chunk one or thin it, he'd always make the comment that, oh, I swung too hard, and then watch out for the next one, because then it would come in even slower, and who knows what could happen. And if he did hit it solid, it didn't go as far as the ones he was hitting before, which I thought were way underpowered, I guess we could say. And finally, I got to a point where I had to figure out what was going on here, and I felt that in this case the best thing was for him to tell me. So I asked him, and I said, "What are you thinking about in your downswing to impact?" Because I'd already told him a little bit about I'd like him to, so to speak, buff up and hit it. And hit it, you know, with a little bit more energy and a little bit more speed, swing his arms faster. But it wasn't happening. Or if it was, it was so minute. It wasn't anywhere near enough. And finally, after him telling me what he did, what he's thinking about, and making the swing, you know, I want to stay three quarters, and I want to make sure that I start this downswing with the bump or whatever. And he went through things. And I said, well, what is your exact thought about impact? And he said, my number one thought is I want to make sure that I square the club up at impact. And I said, okay, what does that mean? He says, well, I have to make sure that I can get back here and really square that club up. And that I think was the absolute answer to his issue. I mean, to stand here and square the club up at impact, and in some cases where a lot of people think that they're supposed to see impact, you can't be swinging very fast. If you're trying to make impact happen, I've heard people say, I'm trying to memorize my impact position. Impact is that fast. It's one half of one thousandth of a second. That's 0.0005. You can't really try to square up impact and see it and truly feel it, because it's too fast. It's like, I use the example, I say to people, all right, go over there about 30 steps. I want you to come running over here as fast as you can go. And one of these times you're going to keep running over here, I'm just going to stick my foot out and trip you, and we're going to practice falling. It's pretty hard to practice falling, but I think you get a better chance of practicing that than you can of trying to learn to feel and see impact and to absolutely perfectly square the club up. All we know is that the arms rotate back to perpendicular to the ground every time we swing them in front of our body. So that's why the peak, that's why the surge swing is a limited turn, three-quarter backswing, and the palms stay perpendicular to the ground throughout the swing, where we take it into the catcher's mitt and up the tree, swing down, hit the ball, and go into the forward catcher's mitt toe up. So if your toe up on this side and you swing the toe up on that side, you know that by your anatomical design, the way God designed your arms to move, they will get back here to square at impact. And the last big issue of that is to make sure that you're parallel left, and they will always square up to impact here if you're parallel left of your aiming line with your body, toe, knees, hips, shoulders, and eyes all lined up. You have to know that and just do it. And so the key to hitting the ball and solid and straight is a square impact. But a square impact is best achieved by you take any thought out of your mind that you're going to, that you have to do it and sense it and feel it and see it. It can't happen. All you can do is know that if you're approaching the ball correctly from here on the aiming line where it squares up and then swings through to the toe, catches mid toe up, you go from toe up on the downswing to toe up in the forward swing, it will be relatively square every time. A good drill is to feel, stand here like this and hold your palm, your forward palm perpendicular to the ground, just come back and slap it and go up there. I mean, how long is that slap? Can you really truly see your hand slap the, you know, your backhand slap your forward hand? If you can, you got phenomenal eyes. But whatever you slapped it at, the club is going probably two or three times faster now when it hits the ball. So success to hitting a ball, swinging at a reasonable degree of power, or as I call athletically ready, and hitting it with energy and swinging near your power, is to get into the, is to approach the club, toe up on the way down, strike it, and swing up, toe up on the way through. And when you're swinging it, toe up back here to toe up over there and up the tree, you'll be hitting it more solid and more straight by just letting it happen. And so that's the key. The golf swing, you got to have faith, get that good setup, and just make that swing and swing up to your tee finish, and you'll be going through impact square and more solid, a heck of a lot more, if not all the time, and hitting it more solid and straight. And that's the secret to hitting good shots and shooting lower scores. Well, that's it for the search today on let's just swing the club and swing it to the best of our abilities within reasonable control, and you're going to be playing a lot better golf. Okay, and I'll be talking to you all again soon.